maybe help other people.
Being more okay with yourself. Like, what bothers you about yourself?
I just wish I just felt more comfortable in my own skin a lot of times, you know, because I feel like I would be able to be more effective as a person if I could just, like, kind of get a, not toil in some of my own, you know, if small self-worth issues or, like, lack of confidence at times. You know, I wish I could trust my instincts, and I wish my instincts were, like, better calibrated so that I knew when I was, what if I was doing, like, okay and good stuff, then my insides, like, told me, you're being okay. You don't have to worry, you know?
There's a lot of things going on there, right? One of them, the big one, is almost always from your childhood. Almost feelings of lack of worth and self-worth come from that feeling as you're developing, as you're growing up.
Yeah.
You feel like you're not loved, or you're not appreciated, or you're criticized too much. You feel like you're a loser. And it really be psychologically can be very hard to shake. And even as people get older, sometimes they still cling to this thought that they're a piece of shit, because they're a piece of shit in someone's eyes when they were 8 or when they were 10. That's a real problem with people, man. And that's one of the reasons why when someone gets bullied when they're young, it can be so devastating, because it's happening when you're in high school or junior high school, and it becomes a defining moment for you, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, it's...
I was scared of this one kid.
Really?
Oh, so bad. This one kid... one of the reasons why I got into wrestling, this kid, we had this confrontation in a locker room, and I didn't think we were going to fight. Like, I was just totally bluffing. I don't know what I said or what he said. I don't remember, but I do remember him getting me in a headlock, throwing me on the ground, and then leaning like he was going to punch me in the face, but deciding not to. And I didn't know what to do. I had no martial arts skills, know nothing.
Right.
I'd never wrestled anybody before. I didn't know anything.
So there was nothing in you that, like, a reaction.
I panicked. I had no idea what to do. And I thought, shit, I didn't think he was going to do that. And now here I am on my back. I'm trapped. Like, God damn it. I got to learn how to wrestle. I got to learn some martial arts or something. So then I started taking karate, and then I started taking wrestling, like, right after that. But I avoided that kid every time I saw him.
Wow.
I'd like see him on the other side of school. I'd like see him through the breezeway, and I'm
you
like,
always knew where he
I gotta
was.
Go around. I gotta go around.
Yeah.
I don't want to see that guy that threw me on the ground and could have punched me in the face. It was almost like more humiliating
that he didn't.
He could have punched me in the face, but he didn't. But that bullying and that guy doing that to me, that fear of like being just helpless, made me get into martial arts.
Right.
I was like, fuck this. Like, I gotta figure out how to fight. I don't want this to happen to me anymore.
So do you see that?
That was the benefit. It was a lucky situation too. Like, he didn't beat me up. It could have been way worse. It was not that big a deal. It was an easy school to go to. Like, my school wasn't hard. Even though there were some criminals that were in that school, like some kids that got shipped into, there were some bad kids. And one of them got charged with murder, like, right after graduating. We were like, whoa, our friend Kevin, we knew this dude, and he killed somebody. And we're like, whoa.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, everybody was like, whoa, that guy killed somebody? I think he was 1 year older than me. Yeah, he murdered somebody, like, right after high school.
What?
Yeah. There's a kid we knew. He was on the football team. Like, we like, knew him. And then,
would you ever think he would murder somebody?
He was a tough guy.
Yeah.
He was a scary guy, for sure. Like a powerhouse of a person. Like a tank. I didn't know him well, though. But I'd say hi to him. But it's one of those things where when something like that happens to you, and for me, again, it was very minor. I was just scared of this guy. And he didn't do anything to me horrible. Just threw me on the ground.
So in hindsight,
somebody could have beat your brains. I mean, if somebody could hold you down like that, that dude could have beat my face in. I wouldn't have been able to do shit.
Are you grateful in a weird way that he didn't? Or not grateful,
oh, yeah,
but looking
for
back
sure,
on it?
For sure. But it was enough. He just let me know. I was, you know, I don't know what I said. I may have said something stupid. He might have said something stupid and wanted me to back down, and I didn't. So he just grabbed me and threw me on the ground. But the fact that he did it and could do it led me to make one of the biggest decisions of my whole life, is getting involved in martial arts. I just didn't want that feeling anymore. If someone gives me a hard time, I want to be the one who can decide whether or not this gets violent or who gets hurt. I don't want to leave that into some stranger's hands who might be a fucking psychopath.
Yeah.
If it's in my hands, no one's getting hurt. We're going to be fine. Like, there's a video of Matt Serra from yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Matt Serra, there was a drunken altercation with some fucking dude in a food court. Matt Serra, who's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. Like, at one point in time when he was competing, he was one of the best Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu artists in the world. Then on top of that, he fought in MMA, knocked out George St. Pierre, won the welterweight title. And he's got some dude on the ground, and he's just saying, calm down, calm down. The guy's like, I'm going to fuck you up. I'm going to fuck. But it's hilarious to watch. Like, look at this. Look at this. Play, get good and play the volume. He's like, I'm going to break your fucking face.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Look at, he's holding his wrist.
I love how he has a shirt on the guy's face.
He's like, calm down, calm down.
It's like he's putting a crying baby to sleep.
And so the security guard comes over and says, let him go. And he goes, okay, you going to control him?
Calm down.
I'm going to cheer you, fuck this guy.
Calm down, calm down.
I'm breaking forward.
Are you going to control them? He says, are you going to control them?
Are you ready to control them?
Are you ready to control him? Like, he's not. He's standing up, and he's fat. Like, and let me tell you something. Matt Serra is one of the nicest fucking guys on the planet Earth. If he has to do this to you in a restaurant, if he's a restaurant, he's got full mount on you. You fucked up. You fucked up, dude. But see, you're way better off with Matt Serra in that position than that drunk dude on some guy who doesn't know how to fight. It could be that, too. That drunk dude could just be a real mean, violent person who wants to beat someone up if he gets them down.
So if there's guys like, you know, who aren't into that kind of, so you found getting into martial arts, it really kind of led you in like a way where you felt more confident in case things got into an uncomfortable situation that you would be okay.
Yeah. Well, look, you're always going to be nervous in life when something's important, whether it's going on stage or something difficult in life. You know, difficult things make you nervous. It's like there's an anticipation. There's an understanding of the difficulty of something you're about to pursue and whether or not you're going to fall short or whether or not you're going to succeed. Mm-hmm. That shit makes people nervous. But the physical confrontation nervousness is a bad one. That is a paralyzing fear. When you fear of being bullied, or fear of being hurt, and you can't do anything about it, that devastates people. That puts them in a deep, deep depression.
Yeah.
So it's really important to learn. I think every young man should learn how to fight. I think there would be way less fights because of it. Mm. And I don't think you have to be a mean person to learn martial arts. I think it's a skill, and I think you learn it, and then once you start getting good at it, it starts actually becoming fun. And the people who you practice it with, you become close with.
Yeah.
You don't hate the people that you're practicing fighting with. They become some of your closest friends.
Yeah.
And I think it's it's a giant confidence boost to know that you can do something difficult and get better at it. I think just that alone, it has massive benefits for people.
Yeah, you know, I can sense that, man. I remember watching a video a couple of years ago, actually, of you like getting a belt or something they gave you at some dojo, or I'm not sure what the correct terminology is. It might have been a BJJ.
Well, you were probably
thing.
Watching when I got my black belt.
Yeah, maybe that was it. But there was a lot of guys around. And I know that Coco does it. Joey does it.
Joey loves it. You should do it. Why don't you do it? You're a strapping man.
I talked to Eddie Bravo about going to do it one day.
You should do it.
So he said, yeah, come. He said, come down one day and he'll, you know, get me into like one of the beginner's classes. I think I need
to
do it.
Dude, fuck yeah.
It'll make me feel a little bit more, like you said, sometimes I just, I don't know, and especially like if people get bullied and then they don't have like a brother or they don't have a friend or they don't even have somebody to go like talk to be like, oh man, and then their buddy to be like, oh, it's okay, you know, like that can make, you know, then that person gets stuck inside themselves just feeling like, you know, like they're not gonna be okay, you know?
No, it's terrifying.